Now that you've determined the gauge that you're knitting with, you're ready to begin the mitten. And you can either use this on yourself if you're knitting the mitten for yourself or for the person that you're knitting the mitten for. Either way, this next measurement is a very important measurement and will determine the overall finished size of your mitten. You need to measure around the widest part of your hand or the hand of the person the mitten is for, not including your thumb. So for most of us, this right here is the widest portion of your hand. So you can take a piece of yarn, or you can use a measuring tape, it's up to you, and wrap it around like this and figure out what that measurement is. On my hand, that measurement is 8 inches. This is the time when we get to use our math and convert this information into our pattern. Because mine is 8 inches and I'm going to make my mitten today to fit my own hand, I need to take the number of inches around my hand times the number of stitches in my gauge, and this is the number across, not the number up and down, and that will determine how many stitches we need to cast on to begin our mitten. On my hand, because the measurement around is 8 inches and my gauge is 4 stitches per inch, I would multiply 8 times 4 for a total of 32 stitches. Whatever number you come up with, you need to add an additional 4 stitches to that number to cast on. The reason that we're adding the additional stitches is to compensate for the seam that we're going to have at the end. So for me, I would need to cast on a total of 36 stitches.
Thanks for watching. Click on the next step or replay to watch another video, and please rate, comment, and subscribe. You can also visit AmericanKnitter.com to purchase the knitting DVD set.